Hello, my name is Dr. Ray Sound. Welcome to this introductory course in interplanetary musicology. In this course, we will look at the music of the solar system, one orbit at a time, starting off with the music of Venus. That was music from the Magellan Symphony Orchestra. Venus is the innermost inhabited planet and the closest planet to Earth. The surface of Venus is hostile. Temperature and pressure are extremely high. The atmosphere is unbreathable and very dense. However, a structure filled with normal Earth air will float at a height of 30 miles above the surface, where temperature and pressure are comparable to those on Earth. So at this level, sky cities float in the strong circulating winds. Venus has hundreds of sky cities, each with its own history, culture, and music scene. The largest and oldest sky city is Magellan, which floats at an equatorial latitude. It's home to over 1 million people, and some of Venus's best known musicians, including perhaps the biggest pop star in the solar system. Sister Green Eyes. The music of Venus is very varied, with each sky city having its own sounds and styles. Overall, though, Venus's music is very forward-thinking and modern. New styles spread and evolve quickly, in part because travel between sky cities is easy and cheap, so bands can tour regularly. One interesting scene can be found in Nouveau Bamako. The optimism of this new city can be heard in the music. Venus is close to the sun, so solar panels are very efficient, making energy plentiful and clean. Its gravity is similar to Earth, so a lot of everyday life in the sky cities is recognizable to us. Travel time between the Earth and Venus is short, so there is a lot of cultural exchange between the sister planets. Of course, this includes touring windows for Venus's bigger bands to play here on Earth. The first time a Venus-born musician played on Earth was the Polaris concert at the Bataclan in Paris, immortalized on this historic LP.